While commemorating the NGO and CBO's Day in Buikwe District today, leaders in the district expressed concern over the increasing number of organizations registering NGOs and CBOs, yet they're actually doing nothing in the communities.
And I'm telling you, if your briefcase organization under my leadership, as the chairperson of Buikwe NGO Network, we shall not allow you in Buikwe District. You will go and operate somewhere else. But here, we want organizations that are adding up, that are adding on something to the district.
Christopher Chobe, the chairperson of Buikwe District NGO Network, reveals that many of these organizations register as non-profit organizations, yet in actual senses, they are business enterprises, while others go ahead to extort money from locals, promising them a number of things.
But you find that many organizations are just there. They are doing their own things. They are conning people. Others have gone on cheating people, you know, extorting money on, you know, to people, and nobody is taking care of them.
Chobe and the district leaders revealed that as a district, they have launched a campaign that will see all non-operational CBOs and NGOs wiped out of Buikwe District.
We have so many organizations that are not registered. When you ask them, they tell you, they came, they saw us, but they told us to pay 80 million so that we can register. And when you go to the Ministry of Agenda, they will tell you, these are the programs, these are the requirements, and when you look at the requirements are okay, they are not really so bad, somebody can afford to register.
All NGOs must comply with the guidelines of the NGO Act or they face consequences.
It requires this organization to be compliant. So if an organization, whether CBO or a non-government organization, is not compliant, that means we shall withdraw its permit to operate in the district, or we shall not permit it to do what? To operate in the district.
Meanwhile, the NGOs also expressed concern over the exorbitant fees levied on the NGOs by the government, which has forced many of them to close.
So we are asking the government to reduce on the taxes. You find that if you find that there is an organization in a community, all the time, you know, the sub counties, the municipalities, they keep on knocking on their door all the time for different taxes. We want this, we want this, we want this. Yet their work is to help the community.
But our work, even if they did, our work as a district monitoring committee is to scrutinize their work, scrutinize their objectives, and ensure that they are in tandem with the government, the objective, the policies of the government.
At the beginning of the year, the government closed dozens of NGOs over non-compliance to the NGO Act and failure to submit their annual returns as required. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.